Okay, so we'll continue the discussion of the longest common substring problem. We have already looked at the top-down approach with recursion using memoization. We have also looked at the bottom-up approach, and this solution right here is the bottom-up solution, where we start from 0,0 and build the array till nm, and we return the value of nm. Now what we are in this video we are looking at is improving the space efficiency. Right now, for the space part, we are using an auxiliary array of size n times m, and we are going to here look at if we can improve it. So if you look at, just to go through this code quickly, basic idea is we start from zero. First row, when we are doing bottom up, we are going row by row, and so we start with 0,0. The idea is, let's say if we are at 1,2. So this you can also see, if you add 1,2, then if the last elements, that is a element first in the first letter and the second, first letter in the first string, the second in the second string, if they are the same, then the lowest common substring is 1 plus this. If they are not the same, then the lowest common substring's length is maximum of this or this, which is what this part is. So for any element, all we really need to know is these three things. So instead of taking a two-dimensional array, maybe we can just take two single-dimensional arrays, call this is a previous array, call this as a current array, and build the current array. So we'll try with that approach. So by using that approach, we can perhaps improve the space efficiency from, you know, n times m, or let's, you know, basically quadratic, which is m square, if the n and m are both the same, to around 2 times m. And let's do that approach quickly. So you know what, problem should be the tester or the caller, let him not worry about creating an auxiliary space. He'll just give the strings and their lengths. So he gives the strings and the lengths. And you know what, he can just give the strings, not even the lengths. So he just gives the two strings, which is what the actual problem is. Now we can get the lengths. Now we can do n cross m, we can do m cross n. It's easier to do the one, you know, which is smaller as a column, but for simplicity, let's say they are equal or something, but we'll just take two dimensional arrays and we'll do, you know, n cross m. So we'll take two arrays, previous is new int of m, and current as new int of. So first is n, second is m. We'll take both as m because we ultimately number of columns. Number of columns is the length of the second string. So we get this. Now, we walk through this and all this is good. Let's get rid of these from the previous code. If there's zero, then what do we do? If the characters are equal, then what do we do? If they are not equal, then what do we do? So the idea is, if they are equal, then current rows, column J, will be zero. If they are equal, then it will be 1 plus previous. So we have the previous row, this is your current, and they're same, so you have to go here. So the previous rows, previous column. So previous represents the previous row. To go to the previous column, we just do J minus 1, and if they they're same, then it is max of, well, current row's previous column or previous row's current column. And once we generate this, now moving on to the next column, we will copy it over. So we make previous as current now. We make it one bigger. And at the end of this thing, we return current of M. What is his problem? His problem is he returns in current. So let's see if this works. Some problem. Missed this part. Okay. So we got 4, which is we have been getting just to review. These are the two strings. M, J, A, U is the longest common substring whose length is 4. So we reduce the space complexity from M times N to 2 times M. We can even further reduce it, you know, instead of taking 2 arrays, can we do it with just 1 array? Can we do that? Is another question. So instead of like 2 arrays, from the previous row, we need this guy and this guy. In the current row, we need just this. So let's say we computed this previous row, right? And which view, let's say we only have one row. So when we come here, before computing it, so what I'm saying is, you know, it actually is 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 2, and 0, 3. As in when we compute, it changes to 1, 0, but this is still 0, 1. Then we change it to 1, 1. So the point is, when we are calculating this, the previous two elements from the previous, these two, we already have. We have the previous here, sorry, this guy, and we just, if we want to do current row's previous, we just change this guy. And because we change this guy, we lose this. So maybe one extra variable for saving diagonally opposite. And other than that, we have everything, all the things we have. So we can even reduce it to one array instead of two. And we can call it now result array. And we can take a previous variable. Now this has to be a little bit careful with this, but we'll try and do it. So now we do result of J is 0, which is no problem at all. Then if the elements are same, then it is 1 plus previous of J minus 1, which is the diagonally opposite. Let's say we save that previous diagonally opposite in previous. We have to see how we adjust previous, that will come to. And this is the case, then it will be, well, now this is something that you need to understand. This current of J minus 1 we don't really need if you're taking one variable, if you're taking one array. So when we do previous of J, you can almost do it the same as result of J, because we haven't yet overwritten it. That means it is of the previous row. And this guy we have overwritten, so this we get easily. So only thing is this previous. How do we update this previous? So this previous is for the next guy, so that is if you get this ij, then when you go to the next row, when you go to the next row, you start your previous as what? So because we are doing from zero, whatever we thinks, what are the funds we do, we have to do here. We don't need this anymore. We'll return result of M. And let's say we start previous as 0, that is no problem. So for the first row it will do like this, for the second row. So this is the first row, right? Now for the second row, when you start, for this guy you don't need, you won't need the previous. For this guy you will need the previous. So for this guy also you will need the previous. So let's say you take a backup of this guy. So you need to understand this. We only have a single array, but we are overwriting it. So this is also current, and this is also current only, but we are overwriting it. So when we are updating this, we have the previous as this, which is not a problem at all. But when we change something, we need to change the previous. So the point is, when I change this, for this guy the previous element, let's say, was something. Now this 01, this is what you have here, right? So you had 01. For this guy, 01 is the previous, but you change it. If you change it, then you lose it. So before changing, you need to save it. And for the next column, whatever here there was, that is the previous. So you take the backup. After you change it, you do previous is equal to backup. And for every row when you start, so for every row when you start, this guy won't need previous, because it will be 00, result will be this, but we still do a backup and we still do this, which is, I think, is fine. So you should start with previous as 0. So the first element will start the previous, and you change the first element. Before change, you take the backup of that, and then you make the previous as that. So this previous, this will be used as the previous for the next guy. All right. This is a more extra space efficiency for even more, you know, people who are more crazy. So let's check whether it works. So we still get 4. So the idea is we are using one array instead of two, and for the previous row, the point is because we are overwriting, but we are not yet overwritten. So we get the element at the same column in the previous row, because that's what we are changing now. We have the element at this current row in the previous column, and for the element in the previous row and previous column, we keep a variable, and we use, you know, be extra careful about how we are updating that variable.